I'm Carlo from the Monorender team, and I would like to share a tip that we use to build stadium seats along the stadium steps with the new geometry node. So make sure to download the latest alpha, because we are using some nodes that are available only in this software. So let's say you have a seat that you would like to spread on a stadium curve or perimeter, like something like this one here. So first thing you need to do is to create the stadium step. To do that, just create a plane, collapse it on the center, extrude it to the height of the seat, and extrude it on the y-axis by some amount. I choose 1 meter. Now we got this element, and let's extrude it on the x-axis by 0.5 meter. Sorry. One thing we need to do now is to set these two vertexes to a vertex group. So now I'm creating and assigning a group. Let's say call it C. Seats. Okay. Now that we have our basic step, you use the array modifier to increase the number of elements. The first array modifier is using the relative offset, is made to build the step in height. So you can see now that if I increase the count, I can increase the height of the step of the stadium. Then we create another array modifier, this one on the x-axis. You can see that if I increase the count, I'm multiplying this object. To make sure that this object is a whole mesh and not some disconnected elements, we have to enable the merge option in each one of those. Okay. Now, what we need to do is to curve this, let's call it an extrusion, this extrusion along the curve object. To that, just add as a modifier the curve modifier picking the object. Now, you can see that it was deforming on the x-axis, which is the one that I'm using to moving the object along. So now if I increase, you can see that the stadium steps follow the curve rightly. We can also, instead of using a fixed count, use a curve. So we can pick this object. And now if I select the curve, I can extrude it another time. Something like this. The steps are interactively following the object, right? Now we go to the geometry node part, which needs to have another editor open. So here going geometry node. In the modifier stack, I add a geometry node. Here it is. You can see now that the geometry or output comes from the geometry input. Let's say I disconnect these pieces one here, and the object is not visible anymore. So the first thing we want to do is to extract these lines, one for each step, so we can replicate this object right here on each one of them. To do that, we take advantage of the vertex group we used. So from the initial geometry, we go into the geometry section and choose the delete geometry. So we take the initial geometry, we delete it, using the seats attribute, Okay, you can see now that we got only the geometry that belongs to the sixth vertex groups. Then we need to convert this object to a curve. So I go into the curve, mesh to curve. And we can see that now we got this this new object, which is a curve. And now we need to distribute some points along the curve. So I pick the curve subdivide, curve 2 points, sorry, curve 2 points here. And you can see that now I have some points that are following our curves. I can increase the count, something like that. And now that I have some points, I can use a point instance, okay, which allow me to pick as a object to instance this seat. Let's connect the geometry right there, and you can see that now the seat has been placed right along our curve. Let's now adjust the rotation. So before the points and the point instance, we place a point rotate node modifier. Okay, you can see now that they are not following the right curve. So let's try to fix that by rotating on the z-axis by 90 degrees and the y-axis other 90 degrees. Okay, you can see here that we have some weird effects. That's why we are using the object instead of the point rotation, which is more appropriate because the curve has been converted to point. So we just switch to point, and we can see now that the seats are facing the right direction. We can increase the count, but better than that, we can choose the length option and specify a length distance between each one of these instance, something like that. So 0.6, I think it's more appropriate. Last thing we need to do is to bring back the initial geometry. We simply add a geometry, join geometry node right there. When we pick the initial geometry and we join it with the one below. Okay, the result is a mesh which is fully controllable with the curve. So if I go on in extruding these elements, you can see that now the mesh has all the seats right at this place. So I hope you enjoy this small tip for Blender, and see you next time.